Hello, everyone. Where the heck do I begin? It's been a while since I've made a video. You guys have been pestering me for quite a while to make another one. Well, I won't exactly say pestering, but your continued interest in my videos has been heartening to me to keep trying. Just kind of a quick recap of everything that just kind of happened to me over the past few months. Last day of February, first day of March, I ended up in the hospital for emergency surgery. I had an ovarian cyst that I didn't know I had, rupture inside my ovary, which caused it to go bad on me. Really, really bad on me, and I ended up having to have surgery to have it removed. Worst 12 hours of my life. I was in a lot of pain. Took 2 weeks of recovery to even get back to my jobs, and even then I had so much going on that the videos got sidetracked, and I apologize for that. For any of you guys who were patiently waiting for part two of the Diagonal Weave video to come out. Speaking of which, I will be getting to that shortly. I just felt like all of you who have been very loyal and watching the videos that I have put up, thank you so much for your comments. I have tried to answer questions as best I can when they come up. Hopefully this next video will help you guys figure out what to do next in the diagonal pattern, and then hopefully over the next few months, I will be able to get more of the videos up. Once the diagonal is finished, I'll be moving on to Chevron, which a couple of people have been asking about. So without further ado, I will start back on with the diagonal pattern. So give me a second and I will be right back with you. All right, just to kind of pick up where we left off here. I weaved this project for a little bit and got, as you can see, quite a bit of length. You can go as long or short as you want with this. It doesn't matter as long as you have the yarn. I like having double wrap belts, so I went as far as I could possibly go with it while still having a couple of inches left for fringe. Now, about the fringe, you can do this any number of ways. You don't have to fringe your belt in order to tie it off. If you want to just tie it in a knot at the end, like so. You know, that's perfectly okay. You can do that. That's the quickest and easiest way to tie it off if you want to. Fringing, when I refer to that, I mean by braiding the ends. This is also a good way to tie it off to make sure it doesn't come undone. As I've done here with this last bit here, these are three strands that have been braided together. You can also take that last bit and you could tassel the end if you want by taking that braid, wrapping it around, and then tying it off, and then cutting this even to where it makes a tassel. You can also do that. There's any number of ways you can do that. You could also cord the ends if you want to. Cording is the two-stranded rope braid that you see some people doing. I'll show you how to do that real quick. What you'll want to do is you'll want to tie a quick double knot in the end, like so, just in case if it does come undone, you don't have to worry about it. And then look at the way that the yarn twists. You'll want to tighten that twist. Most of the time it will be going the same way, and it should be going the same way. So tighten the twist in the yarn itself. So in my case, it's both going right. So I'm tightening the twist of the yarn to the right, and then I'm twisting them together to the left. And that's how you do a two-stranded cord braid. It's very common in rope making and stuff like that. So once you get all the way down to the end, you just kind of keep tightening the individual threads to the right, and then you wrap them together to the left until you get to the length that you want. And when you tie it off, it'll stay together in that neat little rope braid. Now, I personally don't do it very often. I prefer the braided look. It was the first thing I ever learned with it. I've only ever really experimented with the cording. But then again, that's my personal preference. It's really up to you how you want to tie this off. And really, it's just any way you want to, really. So, yeah, those are the kind of different ways that you can tie off the end of your work there. You can either braid it, cord it, or just tie it off in a knot, or you can tassel it. It's really up to you. Okay, now I'm going to show you how to take your work off of your dowel rod here and start on the other side. I just kind of have it set back up in the middle here. And, of course, the first thing you'll want to do is you'll want to start undoing your braid. This is going to take a while, so I'm really not going to make you sit here and watch it. But just for posterity's sake, I'm just going to do video a little bit of it and talk about it. The diagonal braid is one of those patterns that you can decide for it to have a center point in the pattern, or you can decide for it to not have a center point in the pattern. And I'll go ahead and kind of explain to you how you get the end game for both of those. So I'm going to get this braid undone, and then I'm going to show you what happens next. So if you guys just gonna give me a second, I'll get right back with you. Okay, got the braid undone. That took a little bit longer than I thought. So once you have your braid all undone, what you'll want to do is you will want to flip your piece around to where the loose threads are facing you, like this. You'll want to hold it in your hand like this. Now this is where you will really want a sanded rod, because this is where it really comes in handy. You're going to grab your piece, you're going to grab your dowel rod, and then you're just going to slide the whole thing off. Now you don't need this anymore, so you can set that aside. And then what you're going to do, because you have all those loops in there, you're going to gently pull the loops out, like so. And then you're going to look for that very first thread that you wove, the tail end of that one, and you're going to pull it out, like so. And there you have it. Your piece is officially off of the dowel. This is when it comes in handy when you have two smaller dowel rods or two pencils. That works too. Two small pencils, two small dowel rods, and rubber bands to make a clamp. So I'm going to slide this into the clamp so I have a way to anchor this. Just get the rubber bands here. These bands are not cooperating with me. Oh my gosh. Not everything's perfect, guys. Anyway, once you finally get your clamp on, like so, you can go ahead and get it set up here, and you're ready to start over. Like so. And that's how you take it off the dowel and start on the other side of your project. Now, there are two ways that you can continue this. If you want for there to be no center mark, like none at all, you will want your main stripe, the one that you started making when you did the other side, you will want that to be on the left. So you see how I have my main stripe, the one that I kind of guided the pattern by, the gray and white stripe, that is on the left, because as I weave over, it's going to appear back over here on the right and continue on, you know, just like the rest of the pattern. And once it's done, you're not going to be able to tell where the center is. Now, if you want there to be a center mark, you will want to flip it over. Get it out of here. You'll want to flip it over. You'll want your stripe to be on the right side, And yeah, your thread is going to be also on the right side. But you're just going to weave that back in and then continue on. And then this will bend this way and then continue on. And that way your belt will have a center mark. That's how I'm actually going to do this one. So just so you guys can see how that works, I'm going to go ahead and weave this in. Let me change the angle real quick so you guys can see it a little bit better. I am working with a webcam on a tripod here, so forgive me for the weird camera stuff. Okay, there we go. I think you guys can see that better. Anyway, I'm going to take this thread here, and I'm just going to weave it back under like all the others. And then I'm just going to weave across. And yeah, that's pretty much it. That's how you start on the other side of your pattern. So yeah, any questions are welcome in the comments below. If you guys want me to do a quick review of how to start from the center over again, the other way, just continuing the pattern, there not being a marked center, I can throw together another piece and show you real quick. That's not a big deal. And yeah, I am more than welcome to any questions you guys might have. So I'm going to just weave a couple more times real quick. And there we go. So yeah, this one's on its way to being done. And the pattern will have a clearly marked center because it's going to have a little, it's going to have a V-shaped shape in the middle of it. Well, very extended V. It's going to be more like a house roof shape in the middle. And that's how you're going to be able to tell where the middle was, where I started. So yeah, I'm going to go ahead and weave for a little bit just so you guys can kind of see what I'm doing. And yeah. I think that's about it for this video. Thanks for watching. I'm going to go ahead and stop it there for now. Now that I've showed you kind of how to switch over to work on the other side of your belt, I'll show you the finished project at the beginning of the chevron pattern. Right now I've got to weave this one a little bit first though, so you guys can kind of see. Again, any questions or comments below? I'd love to hear from you guys. Your constructive criticism has been very helpful. And again, thank you so much for watching. I hope you all have a good night. Toodles.